Welcome students. Today we are going to see the module 3, that is network layers. So here I have some of the goals from your syllabus which we are going to complete it. And let's see the first one which we are going to check it out. The first one will be your understanding about the principles behind the network layer services, and we are going to focus how it is going to be utilized on your data plane. And also through that, we are going to see how the network layer service models will be there, and forwarding, routing, how the concept will be built up, how the routers are going to be worked out, the addressing models, and some of the generalized forwarding algorithms, and also some of the internet architectures. So all these things we are going to see in our this module. And along with that, you have to see some of the implementations of your IP protocols and NAT middle boxes. You remember one thing, these all are the things they are going to utilize for your 8th semester project. So whenever you'll do any project, definitely you need to give the connectivity in between them. So that time you have to utilize all these layers, and how the connectivity will be there, how your protocols are working out, all these things you need to give it up. So moving towards your network layer, that is the data plane roadmap. So what we are going to see, for today's class, network layer overview, the data plane and the control plane. And the rest of the things we are going to see it in the, maybe it in the next class. So now moving towards the first topic of your third module, that is network layer services and protocols. And you know that only one diagram we are following from the beginning. So it is quite easy to remember for all of you this kind of diagram. Don't do this car and mobile phone and laptop in the exam center. Instead of this, just do one rectangular box and just write down inside, this is a car. Just a car, so that all of them can understand that it is a car. Don't waste your time to draw this kind of cars, okay? Because this is a diagram which you are going to utilize more of the questions. So you have to remember only these objects are there, and you are going to explain it clearly. And the network, whatever has been provided here, that has to be written very clearly. So let's see what is the network layer. Already we have completed two modules where we have checked the application layer along with that the transport layer. So now we are into the network layer, which is the third layer of our OSI protocol like models. So here, what is the first point? The first point is the transport segment from sending to receiving host. Okay, so what we are going to do, the network layer is going to work out with the segments, and here we are going to send the packets from the sender side to the receiver side. So what will happen in your sender side, it will encapsulate the segments into the datagrams and passed to the link layer. So you know that below to this network layer, there is one more layer, that is your link layer. So whenever any kind of message will pass, it has to go through everything. So if we are in network layer, we have to pass the segments, and the segments has to be encapsulated with the datagrams. Okay. And when it will reach into the receiver end, it will decapsulate. Okay. The segments and the datagrams. So whenever we are going to pass it from your network layer, definitely it will cover this link layer and physical layer. Then it will go towards your receiver end. That's the reason here it has been written that the sender has to send the segments, and the segments has to be passed through your link layer. Now what will happen in your receiver end? As the sender has been sent your segments, the receiver in the receiver end, the segments will get delivered. Okay, so how you're going to be delivered? It delivers the segments to transport layer protocols. It is going to deliver here itself. So now but how exactly it is going to work out? The network layer protocols in every internet devices. It will present in every internet devices. What all are your internet devices? You can see this. These all are your routers. You can see in every routers there is a network layer. Okay, so in every route, here only this much has been specified, but in every routers there will be the network layer. And also where there will be the network layer? The host. From one host to another host, we are sending the segments. That's the reason the network layer will be there in your host to host also, and inside your routers. So you have to remember these things. So this network layer is going to be inside your host and also inside your routers. Now, what do you mean by routers? What is the job of your routers? What it will do is, why the network layer will be inside the routers? This kind of small questions you might get in your Viva. So how you are going to answer this? Why in the routers the network layer is important? What you are going to answer? What it will do? It will examine the header fields in all IP datagrams passing through it. It means that whenever the sender will send the segment, it will attach the datagram. So whenever the datagram has been attached, who will check that things? The router will check, okay? Because with the datagrams, one header field will be attached. So it will examine all these things like your datagrams and the header fields whenever it will pass through it. And also it will move the datagram from input ports to the output ports while transferring the datagrams along to the end-to-end path. It means that suppose you have been used this path to transfer your segment from this host to that host. So what you are going to do is here, whenever you are going to pass through this, so that time what will happen, you can see the network layer will be attached with the same network plane with the router. First it will come from the host to this router, then it will connect to the nearby like any network global ISPs, anything is there, it will send there, then it will connect to the like whichever network you are sending to that network, because it is a home network, it is an enterprise network. You are sending the packets from home network to enterprise network. Whenever you will send the packets from one network to another network, that time you have to go through the global ISP. So here the home network has been connected to your global ISP, and then through that it has been connected to your enterprise network. And everywhere you can see the network segment, network layer is present. So whenever from the input side we have attached the datagrams and we have sent it, so again what will happen, if it will reach over your receiver end, it has to be detached, right? So how it is going to be detached? Who will do that? That is a job of your routers. It will check also, and it will send. You can see here, it will transfer the datagrams from end to end, from input to output ports. So this is the meaning of your routers. Moving towards your next slide, here we have the two key network layer functions. So what all are that? Two key network layer functions. It is very important. You have to remember the meaning, basically how you are going to utilize the network layer functions. What is the first one? Forwarding. What you are going to do in the forwarding? You are going to move the packets from the router's input link to the router's output link. Okay, so whenever, because this forwarding and routing, all these things will be based on your problems, and also some algorithms will be there. So that time you have to remember how we are going to utilize this. So this forwarding function will utilize whenever you are going to send router's input link. You just imagine there is only one router. One side will be input, one side will be output link. So it will move the packets from the to the input link to the output link. one more layer function, that is your routing. What it will do? It will try to route all the packets from source to destination. And also it will follow some of the algorithms. So there are many algorithms are there, which will be known as your routing algorithms. And in this routing algorithm, what will happen? It will just find out the shortest path route, and it will try to move the packets from one source to the destination part. This is one analogy is there, where you're whenever you are taking the trip. So how you are going to, how you are going. So here, this is a concept of your forerunning. It's just an example. And it is a process of getting through single interchange. It means that this is a example of your forwarding, how you are going to just you are moving with the traffic and congestions, and you are moving just with your vehicle. But how the routing will find out? You can see there are many paths, right? So, but routing, what it will do is, it will just find out your proper route and the shortest route to your destination part. So that is a planned one. But in the forwarding, it is an unplanned structure. Wherever your packets will get, they will move. But in your routing, it will be a planned trip. Okay. So moving towards the next one, we'll see how these things and all working out with the network layer. We have here two concepts. One is your data plane. Another one will be your control plane. You have to remember the meaning. Always I'm focusing on the meaning. Once you will understand the meaning, then you can write your own concept, how you are going to explain it. Moving towards your data plane. What is this data plane? This is nothing but this is a local or per router function. You have to remember this. This is a per router function. You have to calculate, okay, per router, how many packets you are going to send. And also it will determine how datagram arriving on router input port and is forwarded to your output, to your router's output port. Here you can see one thing, that we have the router over here. So how I can design my input port? Here you can see whatever is coming through this arrow mark, this is my input to the router. And whatever is coming out, that is 1, 2, 3 has been notified, that is my router's output port. So here this is my packet, and this is my header, and which one is passing towards my router. So there will be many paths, the packets can take to move to your destination site. Okay. This is the concept of your data plane. Now, how it is different from your control plane? The control plane is nothing but it is a network-wide logic. We are going to provide the network-wide logic. How? The question definitely will arise, how we are going to do this? It will determine how the datagram is routed among the routers along end-to-end path from the source host to the destination host. So what it will do? It is going to control over your network, and it is going to find out the proper routes through which the packets or the datagrams with the header files are going to move from your source host to the destination host. And it will have the two approaches. What are the two approaches? The first one will be traditional routing algorithms. Okay, there will be some routing algorithms which has been utilized and implemented till now. So that kind of approaches it can use to find out the proper routes. And also one more approach is there, that is software defined networking, SDN. So what it will do, if you want to send the packets within the remote server, you have to use this SDN service. So now here you can see the first one, as I told you, that is nothing but my data plane, how it is going to work out here. So this per router control plane, okay, individual routing algorithms, components in each and every router, which are going to be interact in the control plane. Here, whenever we are sending any packets, as I told you, we have used the concept of per router, that is nothing but data plane. So now, with that, how we are going to manage this control plane? You can see here my packets are moving with the header through the routers. And there are some one input line but there are three output lines. So that three output lines has been named as 1, 2 and 3. So next, what it is happening? You can see this is a router. So these all are your router services. What will happen now? You can see over here the 0111. Okay, it is moving towards my second line. So you can see the header size, the packet which is named as 0111. What is the output link? That is my 2. Fine. So here this is a problem. The problem will come like in this way, that you have to take any kind of your example, or maybe they will give this kind of tables. So what you have to do is, by seeing the tables, the packets are moving from where to where, you have to notify. So if I will take it as an example, what I will do, I will just pass the header, I'll do the router, I'll give some output port links. Then wherever I want, I can pass it. Wherever I'm passing, that things I have to write in my tables. How you're going to design the table? You have to write local forwarding table, then make two columns. One side is header, one side is output. Header is nothing but your input. So in this side, whatever the packets have come, now the first packet has come, suppose 0111, okay? I'll write 0111. And suppose I'm moving towards my first line, then I have to write 1, okay? If you are moving towards 2, as shown in this diagram, you can write 2, okay? Then what is this 1001? This is the packet which has been come before this packet, okay? So the first packet, when it has been sent, it has taken the way 1 and it has been moved. Then the second packet, when we sent, it has been taken the route 2. When the third packet has been sent, that also took the same output link, that is 2. When the fourth packet has been sent, it has been taken the route 3. Okay. So in this way, you can take it as an example. If the problem will come, how you are going to solve it? In the problem, this kind of table will be there. Okay. So what you are going to do? You have to do the individual diagrams. First, you are going to do, suppose 1001. You have to write instead of this 1001. Then you have to give the arrow mark through 1. It means it is passing through 1. Next, again, you are going to do the same kind of diagram. You have to write 0111, pass it through 2. Just give the arrow mark through 2. Similarly, you have to do 4 diagrams here, okay, according to your header size. So this is the concept of your forwarding. So now what is happening? Where we are going to apply this routing algorithm? What will happen is, once you have forwarded, after that, it can take the routing algorithm to reach into the, it can find out the shortest path route. That time we are going to analyze on the algorithm, and we are going to apply the algorithm. Once we will apply the algorithm, it will be provided to all these tables. Okay. So till here, you are going to learn about the data plane, and above to that, you are reading about the control plane. So the two approaches we are providing in this network layer. Moving towards the next one, I told you the concept of SDN. How it is going to work out? Let's see that. So here, this is nothing but remote controller computes. So what is happening? It installs the forwarding tables in the routers. How it is going to do? So now this is my packet, which has been moved towards my second one. What will happen? This is a host. This is another host. So here, what will happen? There is a remote controller in between both the host. Whenever the packets we are sending, definitely there will be a remote controller. What will happen? They will have their own tables. Okay. So how it is going to work out with their own tables? So whenever we are going to, as I told in the last example, whenever we are creating the forwarding table, that forwarding table, it is going to be connected directly with your remote controller. And that table's data will transfer to your remote controller. So the first router will get attached with your remote controller. Similarly, how many routers will be present in one of the network, all of the routers will get connected with the remote controller. So what will happen here, as we have not applied the algorithms, so here what will happen, the down part, whatever you are seeing, that will be under your data plane, and the upper part, whatever the job will be applicable for them, that is known as your control plane. This is the concept of your SDN. Okay. So now moving towards your network service model, here one question arises, that is, what service model for channel transporting the datagrams from sender to receiver? What kind of service model you are giving? So what are the example? What are the service model? There are some example services for your individual datagrams. What are that? First thing is, you need to give the guarantee of delivery that the packets are sending from source to destination. They should reach inside your destination part. That guarantee you should give. Next one will be, it should take the delay of hardly maximum like 40 milliseconds of time or less than that. So if you are not making them to reach within that time period, then this service model will not work out. And also, what will happen in your flow of datagrams, because in the individual datagrams, you are giving this kind of opportunity. So how you are going to give the flow of datagrams? It will be in order datagram delivery, because everything has to be very sequenced. Okay. If you are not sending towards your sequence datagram, then this service model will not work out. And also there will be the guarantee of minimum bandwidth, because some of the things are there, bandwidth, latency, delay, these things has to be worked out in your network service model. And also there should be a restriction on changes in inter-packet spacing. Whenever you are sending the packets, then to send the next packet, you should give the time gap. If there will be no spacing, then everything will get overlapped in your receiver end and it will not provide you the in-order datagram delivery. That's the reason you should give the packet spacing between the two packets. Okay, so this is known as your network layer service model, where they are giving the quality of service guarantees, where it is there and where it is not there. There are two kinds of models I told you. One is your network architecture. One is how it is going to provide all these things. Service model, bandwidth, loss, order, timing, delay, all these things it can provide. So here, this is the thing. So now, where it is not giving the no guarantee, successful datagram delivery to the destination, it is not giving guarantee, okay, because of the best effort. So what will happen if I will tell that, yes, I cannot give, then that will be a problem. But if I will say that, yes, I can give on these things, then it will be a best effort. The timings, the bandwidth from the end-to-end flow, all these things has to be there. You cannot say no into this, okay? So here, these are the network layer service models for your internet, ATM, all these things. And these things you need to remember, whenever writing the any kind of your short topics, descriptions or anything, that time as a sentence, you can write, yes, in the internet network architecture, the service model is having the best effort. It's not having any kind of bandwidth, loss, order and timings are not provided. Okay, but in ATM, there is a constant rate of the bandwidth and there is a delay. It is providing with a delay. So this kind of things you need to write inside your network layer service model. So how you can give the best effort services? The first thing is very simplicity mechanisms you have to follow whenever you are going to design your network layer. And also the bandwidth. Already I told, the bandwidth is the main application for the real-time applications. If you cannot give bandwidth, then it will start buffering. The performance will be very low. That's the reason you should provide the sufficient bandwidth to the network if you want to make it as your best effort services. And also, there should not be any replicated or duplicacy of data. Whenever you are sending your packets inside your application layer distributed services. What do you mean by application layer distributed services? It is nothing but whenever your all the networks, whenever your all the host or everything will be get connected with a distribution network, That time, this is known as your distributed services, because any of the packets will reach in the data center. They will first check it out, the content distributions, where it has to go. You can take the example of your Netflix. Whenever the contents will reach, first it will find out from which network it has come. So properly with that network, it is going to be distributed with the proper bandwidth to all the data centers. So if there will be any duplicacy of data, then definitely always you can listen the audio or video in the 2x format. Okay. To avoid all these things, it should be replicated and it has to be connected closely with the client networks, which will, because here we are going to send all these services to the multiple locations. So if you have the buffering capacity or bandwidth is very low, then definitely all the clients network, they'll complain. So to avoid all these things, if you want to go for the best effort services, we have to work on the distributed services first. And also it has to take care of the congestion controls to find out the best elastic services. Okay. So these all are everything about your network layer, how the network layer has been designed and how it is going to be work out. Very simple concept. You have to remember some of the technical points and you can elaborate your answer properly. So this is all about your network layer.